clubs, this is easy, with nutritionists, masseurs, physios and sports scientists all on the payroll. But for teams in the lower leagues, keeping up with the big boys can prove that little bit more difficult. But not impossible, as Martin Foyle's Port Vale are currently proving.
From our point of view, yeah, we know we haven't got money, yeah, we're in the real world, but that's the division we're in, that's the job I'm in, but we've got to take the most of everybody's expertise, you know, and I've just got to get that little bit more out of my staff.
I think the clubs in the Premier League, the clubs with the big money, have realised that football is an athletic sport rather than just being, you know, a footballer. Those ideas are filtering down through the courses and through the managers and through people like myself. So I think a club like this can benefit a lot, to be honest.
And benefiting they are, with 5 wins out of 7, the league's top scorer in Leon Constantine, and a place in the next round of the Carling Cup, Foyle certainly is getting the best out of all his staff, in no small part because of the club's scientific approach to the art of football training.
I think a lot of the old school managers, no disrespect to them, are a little bit scared of the technical side, the computers, and I'm probably one of them a little bit myself. I haven't been in the job that long. But I've taken Dave Barron on board this year. He's fully qualified in all areas, and it's not just one area. You know, he's fully qualified for weight training and core strengthening, and that's vital for players nowadays.
There's not a bottomless pit, certainly at this club, but we have to be choosy and think what are going to be the best benefits for the money we've got available. But I think more and more clubs are picking up on the idea that players need to train intelligently rather than just training all day, really.
For Port Vale, who only came out of administration 3 years ago, every penny has to be accounted for and spent wisely. This may frustrate fans left questioning where the cash from the sales of players like Chris Birchall has gone, but bringing in new players might not always be the right answer for the club.
Just had a meeting with the chairman, that's probably why I missed a fair bit of the training today. But no, little things like the heart monitors, you know, we've already got them in, which is very important. And that's the side that the chairman's just gone down with me now. You know, what do we need? It's not all about players and how many extra players and the bigger the squad. It's how can we utilise the best of what we've got, and if it means one or two lone players at certain times, then that's the way we've got to go.
Two pieces of equipment, this is your strap. So this works just attached around the back of the chest with this part in the centre. Just works as a little strap. That records the heart rate and communicates it with the watch, which records it through the session. And when you download it to your PC, this is the information that you get. So along the bottom, this is duration of the session. And we've got the heart rate at the top. So the red line indicates what work the player's done. So when we're trying to evaluate it, we can establish that this part was a shooting session that he did, and this part was a small-sided game that he finished with at the end. And this was from Mark McGregor, who's a centre-half.
From my point of view and the staff, we've had a good chat all season about how we're going to plan for this season. We finished 13th last year, 18th the year before. It's been a steady progress. You know, obviously financially we're just getting a little bit more wealthier, but they don't see it all the time. But no, I'm looking top 10 playoff place, and it's surprised. I think there's going to be four teams that are going to, the big spenders are going to be out of the way. And there's going to be a lot of places up for grabs, and if we can perform at home and turn the one-pointers into three-pointers, we could have a good chance this year, but we've got to be injury-free.
Well, nothing's changed in football. Imagine Port Vale having a sport